Namaste, welcome to our today's pranayam session. Let's begin by first stabilizing our sitting pose well. You can sit in any comfortable meditative pose of your choice. Any cross-legged position, half lotus, vajrasana, or any meditative pose that you're familiar with. Most important to keep your spine straight throughout the practice. Dhyan mudra or any mudra of your choice. Wrist on your knees. Relax your shoulders. If you want, you can roll your shoulders and bring them down. Keep your neck, face relaxed. Chin is parallel to the floor. Make sure you're not looking down. Chin is parallel to the floor. Maintaining this alignment for throughout the practice if possible, making any necessary adjustments anytime you need to. Let's chant initial prayers. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahana Bhunaktu सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः Welcome, and let's begin with our Viloma breathing, the interrupted breathing. We're going to inhale at the count of 4 in steps and also exhale in 4 in the steps. So something like this, and then exhaling also step by step. You have to exhale. It's very normal to have some shoulder movements in this practice, but make sure you're not moving it too much. Just keep your shoulders as relaxed as possible, just focusing on the full complete inhalation and complete exhalation. So let's begin. Keeping the spine straight, any mudra of your choice. Close your eyes. Let's first observe our natural breathing. See how the breath is flowing in and out. Rhythmic flow of your breath. Staying connected to your breath throughout the practice. And now let's begin with Viloma breathing, the interrupted breath. Breathing in and out in steps. Exhale completely. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale 1, 2, 3. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale 2, 3, 4. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4. And relax. Natural breaths. Now let's take a deep breath in and breathe out completely. We'll be now doing some more rounds of Bhastrika today, inhaling and exhaling through both the nostrils at a faster pace. Anytime you want to use your arms up and down, you can do that, or you can just keep Drona Mudra like this on your knees to relax your abdominal muscles. So we're going to do Bhastrika today, inhaling and exhaling in a rapid manner through both the nostrils, focusing on both the actions now and the chest. So let's begin. Closing your eyes, spine straight, shoulders, neck relaxed. We will do it together today, and at any point if you feel the pace is not right for you, you can just maintain your own pace, take a break and start again. Let's begin. Take a deep breath in, breathe out, and let's start. And relax. Very nice. Observe your natural breath. Observe your capacity, how many rounds or how long you're able to do it. We did it for almost around 45 to 1 minute. So you can see if you're able to do it. It's very natural for any mucus or kind of some water coming out from the nostrils during this practice. So it's completely nice. The cleansing is happening. So do not worry about that. We are going to very soon learn one follow-up practice for Bhastrika. So that is why I also need your feedback today on how are you able to do Bhastrika? Are you progressing? Do you feel less tired than before? So we were going to do one more round now so you can be more mindful on how your body and breath responds to the practice, so that we can learn one more new pranayam tomorrow to add it up with Bhastrika, which has amazing benefits for immunity. So let me know today after the class. But today we will now continue with one more round. You can observe this round and let me know how you feel. Then keeping your eyes closed, Drona Mudra or Dhyana Mudra of your hands. Spine straight, shoulders, neck relaxed. Eyes closed, awareness on the chest breathing. Starting at the slower pace, then picking it up in between, and then again ending with a slower pace. Let's begin. Inhale deeply. Exhale completely, and let's begin. Exhale and relax. Natural breaths. Observing all the after effects of the practice. There's a lot of pressure on the face and head. Slight feeling of breathlessness. Slight feeling of heavy-headedness or disease, completely normal. And gently open your eyes. Very nice. I'm hopeful that many of you would have been able to cope up with the pace. However, if not, do not worry. There's long way to go. Some people would take a little longer time, depending on the natural capacity of the lungs and any practice that you have done before, or how was your normal breathing before these sessions is going to determine a lot about how you progress. So never mind, we all have taken a nice step of at least correcting our breathing and adding up to the schedule. So do not get impatient if you're not getting those quick results. Gradually with practice, you will definitely be there, and all these practices will come very naturally to you. So please do not hurry up in kind of making up the pace to what I am doing or what you think it should be done, right? Fantastic. So let me know on how your Bhastrika went today, because this energizing practices would really need a feedback, just to make sure that you're not overdoing or not having any disadvantages. So please let me know today at the end on how your Bhastrika went today, so I can add up one more nice practice to it, and it is very efficient for immunity. Let's go for our regular alternate nostril breathing now. We're going to inhale at the count of 4 and exhale at the count of 8. Very soon we're going to add one more progressive step in this. So please also check how comfortable you are in doing 4:8 or 1:2 ratio for this practice. Let's begin alternate nostril breathing. You can use your right hand for Pranav Mudra or Vishnu Mudra, and using your another hand in Dhyana Mudra or any mudra of your choice. At some point, we will be also speaking on some different mudras that you can have in the pranayam class. I'm sure that will be helpful for your different needs. So keeping Pranav Mudra in with your right hand, closing your thumb, and closing your right nostril with your thumb. Let's begin inhaling from the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, right exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right inhale, 2, 3, 4, left exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Left inhale, 2, 3, 4. Right exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right inhale, 2, 3, 4. Left exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Left inhale, 2, 3, 4. Right exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right inhale, 2, 3, 4. Left exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Left inhale, 2, 3, 4. Right exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right inhale, 2, 3, 4. Left exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Relax. Gently bringing your right hand down back into any mudra. Observing the after effects. Observe the inflow and outflow of the breath through both the nostrils. Now observe your natural breathing and its rhythmic flow. And very gently open your eyes. We're now going to learn today one new practice, and this is very popular practice in yoga world because this is one breath which can be used while doing multitasking. Like, I know so many schools and students who do this breath while they are holding or doing their asanas, in your day-to-day work, while walking, while in shavasana doing mindfulness. So this breath is really, really like, you know, multitasking tasker's breath, I can say. It is called as Ujjayi breathing. I'm sure for those who have been practicing yoga, pranayama before are aware. We're just going to learn the technique of it quickly today so that we can also put it in our daily schedule. Ujjayi has a lot of benefit again. This is one breath which has two different qualities and benefits which gives at the same time. This breath is also energizing and this breath is also relaxing at the same time. I mean, that may sound contradictory, but that's the fact about this breathing. You can be more mindful when you do Ujjayi because you can hear some subtle sound of your own breathing, and that makes your mind really peaceful and calm and brings you in the present moment immediately. The more you listen to your sound, which means you are not thinking about something else, you are forgetting what was in the past for now, you are not thinking about the future, you are listening to that sound of your breathing, and that gives a lot of relaxation to your mind. So apart from that, Ujjayi breathing has many benefits to your throat. Like, I had few questions few days ago regarding thyroid. So any hormonal imbalances related to thyroid gland will be also helping because we are kind of stimulating that area there by doing Ujjayi breaths. Again, for those who are into singing profession or want to have, you know, this better voice modulations, Ujjayi breathing is really great. Has a lot of benefits. We'll be discussing it more as time comes. So let's understand how to do this Ujjayi breathing. So now, you won't be able to hear me at all, but all I have to do is try my best to explain you on how to do this technique. So Ujjayi breathing is where we contract our throat and we inhale. I know it sounds tricky, like what exactly do you do? So I'm going to give you one easy technique to understand how to understand what is Ujjayi breathing, because you won't be able to hear me. When you also do your Ujjayi breathing, maybe just the next person will be able to hear you, or maybe no. It's like, you know, as if the air is coming from a thin pipe in your throat. That's what we have to do. There's a focus on the throat and we contract those muscles and then we have to inhale and exhale like that. I know, sounds tricky. Let me explain to you. Now imagine you have a mirror in your hand, okay? And now we all are going to fog this mirror as if what we do to the windows in the winters, we just fog it like this sound, right? So I want you all to take your hand in front of you and see as if you are fogging a mirror, right? So I hope you all did it. Now you have to do the same thing with your mouth closed, and exactly the action that is happening is Ujjayi breathing, like this now. This is what I mean when I say you have to contract your throat and breathe in and breathe out. Same thing happens while exhaling as well. So if you can try again, just open your mouth and as if you are fogging the mirror or fogging the window in the winters. So just try that. Like, I'm remembering the Colgate ad right now that we had a few years ago where they're like smelling the breath, something very similar. That's what you have to do. Exhale. Now same action, you're doing it with your mouth closed, and that is Ujjayi breathing. That is the focus, that is the contraction of the throat that happens in the Ujjayi. Okay, so now the more you do it, the more you focus on your throat and contraction of the throat, and as if the air is just coming from a small thin tube or a pipe is what you have to visualize. This breath will sound similar to the ocean waves, or the best example is hissing snake. Or another example is, have you ever seen a small baby snoring? Very similar sound to that. So there are some different techniques in different schools. In the technique that we follow, we don't produce the sound very loud like snoring. We just keep it relaxed like a hissing snake or ocean breathing. So let's try today this breath. So hopefully you have understood the technique through some examples, because there's no way you will be able to hear my breathing now. So we just have to be mindful and be with our this region, moreover your throat region, and then let's try to do around 5 rounds of Ujjayi today. We will increase the number of rounds gradually as we understand the technique correctly. Again, keeping your eyes closed. And just now, if you understood the technique, you can contract your throat muscles. And let's inhale and exhale in Ujjayi for 5 rounds. Once you are done with your rounds, you can gently open your eyes. I'm hoping that most of you understood the technique. If not, do not worry, we will be repeating few more tips on exactly what happens and how it should sound. So we will keep discussing this for a couple of days so you get the practice right. So now let's close our eyes for the positive affirmation and our universal peace prayers. Let's visualize as if we are writing this affirmation on the blackboard, and we will repeat it in our mind throughout the day during all our daily activities. I breathe in energy and I breathe out tiredness. I breathe in energy. I breathe out tiredness. Repeating this affirmation any point, any time in a day today. Now let's chant our universal peace prayers for the well-being of all, and in a mood of gratitude to all those who have helped us. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah. Sarve santu niramayah. Sarve bhadrani pashyantu. Ma kashchit dukha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Gently rub your palms, bringing the warmth of your palms in your face, cupping your eyes, opening your eyes inside the palms, and gently bringing your hands down. Let us surrender today's practice to the Supreme Lord, and let us pray for the well-being of all around us again. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. May all beings be happy. Thank you very much for joining in. And something very special that I wanted to share today quickly is about diet. It's a vast subject. It is very difficult to add on so many things about diet. But definitely all the scriptures of yoga, pranayam practices, they definitely recommend sattvic diet. A sattvic diet is something which is in the mode of goodness. It is full of prana. For example, if I will put some lentils and pulses in the ground, in the soil, in Mother Earth, it is going to grow, which means that food has lot of prana inside. However, if I'm going to put some cookies or some noodles or some pastas in the ground, nothing is going to grow. That means that food does not have prana much. So as you follow pranayam practices consistently, and if you're also mindful of your diet, you will see the changes more quickly. Of course, I'm not right away telling you, okay, stop everything and, you know, just completely go on an aesthetic diet. No, it is not like that. But gradually try to adopt some small changes, some mindful choice in your plate on what you're doing. One thing that definitely the scriptures advise is also having simple food which you can digest easily. So you can now use your discrimination. The world is full of information about easy to digest food, lighter food, sattvic food, fresh food. So we all little bit have an idea about this. So just making a healthy conscious choice will be really helping your progressing journey in a faster pace. And also sometimes as we start to do more dynamic breathing, I feel still we are on a very moderate and kind of an all right pace. But if in future, if you plan to increase your pranayam sadhana, then including cow's milk and cow's ghee is highly recommended even in the yogic scriptures written thousands of years ago, because that is going to supply the necessary lubrication, because sometimes we may feel that our intestines have dried up with the dynamic breath as we practice it more. So overall also it is a very healthy thing to have. So including cow's milk and little bit of cow's ghee in it, or maybe overall in your diet, is recommended, especially for pranayam practitioners, this two food, superfood. So just a simple thing I want to share: have food which is more rich in prana, light, easy to digest. And mostly yogic texts of those times, they do not talk about how much to take, or you know, there is no calorie calculation, there are no description of any micronutrients or macronutrients or minerals and vitamins. They really haven't written all those things in details. However, all they say very wisely is have mita ahar. Mita ahar means having food in moderation according to your body type. So not under eating, not overeating is what usually any of the yogic texts they advise regarding diet. Okay, so be mindful of what you bring on your plate every day to progress in any sadhana that you have been doing. Okay, thank you very much for joining in today. I will see you all tomorrow. Namaste.